Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Real Talk with Robbie Shane. I'm Shane.
I'm Robbie.
And we're brought to you, as we always are, by GimmicksInc.com. You can get in touch with us there. You can also get in touch with us at Facebook.com/GimmicksInc or at GimmicksInc@gmail.com. We're also on Twitter at GimmicksInc. So, today, what are we doing today?
Well, it's been a minute since we've done one of these, so it's kind of good to be back.
Hasn't been too awful long since one's been up. I think we're only up a little over a week.
Yeah.
Week and a half, something like that. But it's been a while. Like, we recorded a couple back-to-back, so it's been 2 or 3 weeks since we've done
this. Yeah, good old wisdom teeth removal will do that to you.
Yeah, because normally when we were, you know, a good poised time when you've got 3 or 4 days off and we can knock some of these out, you know, I had to babysit you there for a little while.
Yeah. Here's so much
that I wanted to, like, do. I was like, oh, man, we should watch a bunch of Netflix shit and get together and be able to do this. And then you can't even remember that you watched Castlevania.
Yeah, I'll have to go back and watch that. It's because I remember the start of it, and that was it. So,
yeah, I think that'd be pretty. I mean, I still think, like, Glow, Castlevania, you need to finish Stranger Things. And I'll try to wrap up some of the Marvel stuff, and we can do an episode or two on Netflix stuff.
That'd be good.
So, I've got to jump into that Marvel stuff. Defenders is in 3 weeks.
Dang, it is.
August 17th.
So which ones you got left to catch up with?
Back 2/3 of Luke Cage and all of Iron Fist.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, I could probably knock it out.
So but... I'm not the only one that has to play catch up sometimes.
No. And I don't understand how I haven't... Well, I mean, this year's been really weird for just watching a lot of series. Like, I'm behind on everything I watch. I saw one part of one episode of the Flash DC TV crossover event.
Oh, wow, the four-parter?
Yeah, and immediately got turned off of wanting to watch it.
Really?
Yeah, I started watching it, and remember how I told you at the beginning of the season, one of the reasons that I stopped watching it was because they did the whole, like, why is Barry mad at Iris thing?
Oh, yeah. And then,
the episode I watched, Cisco hates him.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm like, I'm not doing this crap anymore. Like, I cannot do this everybody hates Barry drama. You know, I'd get that with Flash or Arrow. It's like, everybody hates Ollie. Flash was the one where everybody worked together like a family.
Yeah.
So
thankfully, they resolved that quickly.
Did they?
Because I was like you. I was like, man, are we really going to drag this on and do it again just with another character?
Which I don't even understand. I mean, granted, the kid was, like, from what I gathered, his brother died. But it was like, you don't know that. No, he can. That's the thing. Cisco can look into alternate realities and stuff.
So yeah.
That's how he knew, wasn't it?
Something like that.
Because I know, like, he mentions, like, Diggle gets aggravated. And he's like, I had a daughter. And it's like, yeah, but you still have a son. Like, why are you mad right now?
Yeah.
Like, nothing happened to you, homie. But, yeah, all the decent, like, there's so much comic book stuff on TV that at one point, like, I would have been lapping this stuff up. Like, I remember watching the Generation X show on Fox because it kind of resembled the X-Men.
Yeah.
Much less, like, now that they make a real X-Men show. Like, that has actual X-Men characters, and I can't be bothered to watch it, or a show that had 15 superpowered characters in costume.
That's like what you said, like, back when we only had that, and, you know, Joel Schumacher's Batman, and you were like, man, come on now, I've been in this shit since it was shit. That's still, like, one of the funniest things you said.
That's what we need. I was thinking the other day, we were talking online about, T-shirt ideas. I think that's got to be one of the T-shirt ideas. Like, I've been in this shit since it was shit.
Just put, like, the stupid Venom, like, the silhouette of him.
God, that's a problem. There were still good comic book movies around that time. Like, I'm talking about Meteor Man and crap like that, man. Steel.
But at least we've got good comic book stuff now, it looks like.
That we have, and we are fresh on the heels of San Diego Comic-Con, which is... Unfortunately, we're not like a lot of other podcasters that be like, we're coming to you live from the San Diego Comic-Con floor. It's like, no, we're coming to you live from my floor. And this will be the last time we come to you live from my floor. It'll be all Casa de Rob over at Xanatos Studios.
There
next
we go.
Time we get together.
Yep.
So one day we'll get over to San Diego. Like, that's my goal. Either San Diego, or if nothing else, if I can't make it to San Diego, New York.
Yeah, it's like we want to go to a big con and we want to go to WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And that's it.
And honestly, I'm getting to the point where WrestleMania is give or take.
We want to go to NXT TakeOver before WrestleMania.
I want to go to the Tokyo Dome show is what I want to do. Like, I will tell you that's higher on my priority list right now than going to WrestleMania is going to a Tokyo Dome show.
Gotcha.
Now, that being said, WrestleMania will probably happen long before a Tokyo Dome show. Like I said, we're coming out of San Diego. Big thing out of San Diego. Tons of movie news. Just to go in, I was kind of underwhelmed by a lot of the news from San Diego.
See, year. I was too, but the fact that we finally got the trailer for the movie that I know me and you've been waiting for since we've been friends.
Yeah.
So I think that's probably a good place to open up with.
Yeah. And that's one of the things. I think the fact that we've seen a couple of these trailers, and we're not to bury the lead, we're talking about Justice League. And that was one of the big surprises from last year's Comic-Con, was that we got the first look at Justice League.
Yeah.
And I don't know, like, seeing the new footage and everything was awesome this year, you know, it didn't have that, oh, I can't believe, like, last year was that, this is happening.
Right.
Like, they've actually made this. But, we'll go ahead and start there. The new trailer for Justice League came out. Few things about even going into that. One was all the speculation at whether Affleck was going to be Batman.
Yeah, seems like he kind of shut that stuff down quick.
Absolutely. Like, just comes out and he's like, no, man, this is the greatest job in the world. And, like...
Well, he said that everything's still staying the way that he was contractually obligated to as far as how many appearances and whatnot, because they're just considered Suicide Squad as a walk-on.
Right.
And from what I understand, the scenes with him and Joker and Harley, it wasn't even him. It was a stunt double in CGI.
Right.
So, as far as Ben Affleck being there, he was just there with the Amanda Waller scene.
Yeah, I figure that, and the one scene that you see him in a head-on shot when he's with Deadshot.
Mm.
But he probably wasn't even on set. That's probably just here, stand in front of this green screen in your bat suit real quick.
Yeah, and who knows when they could have snagged that.
Yeah.
Like, throughout production.
That could honestly be something from Batman versus Superman.
Yeah, like, that's what I'm saying. It's like it's just hard to tell when they did that.
But I think the movie looks great. To me, this is the movie that looks the most like a comic book out of all these movies, other than maybe like Sin City or something like
mm-hmm.
that. Like, but the superhero books or movies, this is the one that to me looks the most like a comic book.
Yeah, it's got the kind of gritty look, but still has that, like you said, I guess comic book look.
I mean, it's
the best way to describe it.
Like the first trailer, when you have like the Batman scenes where he's like swinging in front of the, I don't even know what, but you see him swinging from the rope, and it's the straight comic book pose. Like, it's not like you see in the movies where it's stiff bodied and stuff like that. Like, no, he's like legs out, cape behind him.
Yeah.
Like, just awesome looking Batman scene.
Looks like something Jim Lee would draw.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And with this new one, I mean, the scenes where they've got the like completely red sky behind them, and it's just, I don't know, it's something that looks more like a comic book than anything I've seen so far. And I'm super excited for it. Like, November cannot get here quick enough.
I mean, I'm more excited about this. I mean, don't get me wrong, we love Marvel, and you know, when we finally got the payoff of the Avengers.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, man, how long have we been waiting for this movie? At least since 2001, because I know that's when we met.
Yeah.
So, we always talked about DC and like, man, wouldn't it be cool if we finally get a Justice League movie?
We met earlier now.
Was it?
I was still in high school, dude.
Let's see. I'm trying to remember. Well, it was like
99, 2000,
maybe.
Yeah.
Because I know I finished school in 2001. So maybe that's what I'm thinking. Yeah, that's right. Because I was working there.
Yeah, you were already at Walmart by the time.
Yeah, I was still.
I left school.
Yeah, I was still in school when I started that job. So,
but
I wouldn't expect to do math. Leave me alone.
But, I mean, and on top of that, DC announced their new slate. You know, and this is, DC's upcoming slate has changed a few times over the last few years. The slate that they gave this year was, you know, we know Aquaman's coming already.
Uh-huh.
And we know Justice League's coming in a couple months. So they told us we're getting Wonder Woman 2 and Suicide Squad 2. Those are our two major sequels that we're getting.
Mm-hmm.
And they both made money. Wonder Woman's now made as more than any of the other DC movies.
Didn't you say you saw today where it broke Guardians?
It beat Guardians. It's the number two movie this summer.
That's pretty awesome.
It's going to hit, it's $389 million, so it's going to hit $400 million by the end of August. It's, you know, just a tour de force as far as, you know, this is what DC needed. They needed the hit that's money-making and critically loved. Like, I really don't hear much, not even much, I don't hear hardly any negativity about this movie, other than what came out of my mouth. I'm the only person that didn't 100% love it that I've talked to.
You're not wrong. So, yeah.
Like, and I'm not even saying that, and that's not to even pretend like, you can go back and listen to that episode. I didn't say that I hated it by any means or anything. I didn't want to run up and give it a hug. You know, it's just like, hey, man, you did a good job. Let's move on. But, you know, a sequel, absolutely. We knew we were going to get a sequel.
It's set in the 80s?
I think that's what I've heard.
I think they said.
Setting it in the 80s, so you got some Cold War stuff, which is an interesting take on it. And it kind of gets past that idea of, like, sorry, I cut you off.
I was going to say, like, you know, they went to World War One in the first one because nobody did it.
Right.
Now they're going to this one because it seems like nobody does it. So that's cool.
And it gets you out of this run to where, like, one of the things I kept hearing about, I remember Iron Man 3 come out, because Iron Man 3 was the biggest movie that came out after Avengers.
Mm-hmm.
Or the next Marvel movie. And they were like, well, why is this a deal? Why don't they just call the Avengers? You get out of this by setting of something like Wonder Woman in the 80s.
Yeah.
There's not a Justice League. You know, if Wonder Woman's got something major to deal with, why not just call the Justice League?
Yes, and she'll never have that criticism because Justice League isn't together. So
exactly.
That's
it doesn't
really
exist
cool.
At that point. They get away from having to deal with that, and that's a pretty cool idea.
Yeah.
Suicide Squad, of course, that made a lot of money. Now, I'm wondering, I'm very interested, is that Suicide Squad or is that Gotham City Sirens?
No, it's Suicide Squad 2.
Suicide Squad 2.
David Ayer, that did the first one, he's going to do Gotham City Sirens, and they still have a Suicide Squad 2.
They offered it to Mel Gibson.
Yeah, and that didn't work out. No. And they have a guy, but I can't remember right now who it was, because they just, like, I think I heard it on either Fat Man on Batman or something along that line.
Gotcha.
And they were talking about how it does have somebody, but I just can't remember who it was.
Okay. So, well, we'll put Gotham City Sirens aside for a second, because I want to get to that in a minute. So, we got, like I said, Wonder Woman, Suicide Squad 2. Justice League Dark. Looks like that's finally going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Batgirl, the Joss Whedon version.
Yeah.
The Batman. Flashpoint, which I guess they've completely, you know, we kept hearing that they were having trouble trying to figure out what to do with the Flash, because TV had done it.
Yeah, that's what we were going to say, that, you know, they'd always complained about how somebody had already done it for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Or 5 minutes ago. And that's the story that they kind of brushed over in two episodes.
Yeah.
Because remember, one episode was called Flashpoint, the second episode was called Paradox.
Yeah.
And then kind of like, yeah.
See, here's my thing. And my idea was, because I knew they weren't going to do it in the TV show, if they're going to do Flashpoint, to me, you got to go all out. Like, you got to go alternate versions of the heroes.
Mm-hmm.
I need my Jeffrey Dean Morgan Batman.
And from what I was understanding, they're going to try to film it while The Walking Dead is done, so you can get both of them. You can actually get Martha and Thomas back.
Oh, is she in?
Yeah, she plays Maggie that was married to Glenn.
Really?
Yeah.
I guess I never paid attention.
It was so funny because when he got cast as Negan.
Uh-huh.
And let's see, how did it work? I think he was talking about it. He had got cast as Negan, and then he went to go do Batman Superman, and then he met her there first.
Oh, gotcha.
And then they went back to Walking Dead.
Interesting.
So
that's cool. And plus, I mean, the idea of, you know, if they go that route, is she going, you know, can she show up and be the Joker?
She's got to. I mean.
You know, but, I mean, just to me, the idea of having Jeffrey Dean Morgan as, like, the gun-toting Thomas Wayne Batman. Oh, that could just be so cool.
Yeah, that would be really sweet.
It would be really neat to have it in that way, where you've got, like, if you have Ben Affleck's Batman sitting in the Batcave and Barry brings him the letter from Thomas Wayne, like, oh, that could be really cool.
And they could even handle that with kind of how they did Suicide Squad. Just having an extension, like, just a one-off, like, don't really hold it in the contract, but
second,
be like,
you know,
hey, if we need you, can you do this?
Yeah.
And you know he's going to do it.
Yeah.
So.
But, yeah. I think if you're going to go with Flashpoint, and I mean, that being said, at this point, I'm starting to wonder, like, this has to be the thing that sticks and gets this movie made. Because Flash is, I mean, we're on our third director now.
Something like that.
And I don't even think they've announced a new set of directors other than the guys that did the Lego movie want to come back to it.
Yeah.
Because they stopped it to go do Han Solo,
the movie that nobody asked for.
They got opied out of.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I'm interested in that one. Like, that being said, you can market anything with Star Wars right now, with the sole exception of like a Jar Jar Binks story.
And no, somebody would like it.
Somebody would, yeah. That's unfortunate. So Flashpoint, I think they gotta go big. Shazam, which the big thing, Shazam, without The Rock.
Yeah.
I don't understand this.
Yeah, like, why?
Shazam does not have a ton of memorable villains.
Right.
Outside of Black Adam. Black Adam's the biggest guy. And I'm like, you have the biggest movie star on the planet playing him. A guaranteed box office draw.
Right.
Playing a bad guy, which he's never done before, really.
No, not really.
And you're not going to pull that trigger? Like, I don't... My care to see a Shazam movie just died by not knowing that... Wake me up when hopefully it gets to the second one so that I can see them go against each other.
So you're saying your excitement for the first one hit rock bottom?
Pretty much. Pretty much.
Yeah, that one is the odd duck out of that list right now.
Yeah.
Just because of that.
Yeah. And of course, wrapping it up, Justice or Green Lantern Corps.
I know you're excited for it.
I'm excited for it, but oddly enough, it's the one on the list that we know the least about.
Yeah, what was it? It was supposed to be a rumor there for a long time. It's supposed to be like treated like a buddy cop movie.
That's what I've heard.
Both lanterns, which that'll make us happy since...
I'm good with that. Like, I think... Throw all four Earth Lanterns into the movie. Like, if to me, if you're calling it Green Lantern Corps, I need... So many lanterns in this movie, it's ridiculous.
You just want somebody to make up for the last attempt.
Yeah. But, and I'm not as hard on that movie as most people are. And
well, I'm just happy it's got Jon Stewart in it because, you know, he's the real Green Lantern.
We're going to end this show pretty quickly.
But at least we'll both get our Green Lanterns. So that'll be cool.
That's the good thing. Like... Because to me, that's the best way to do it. Because you get that group of people that are like me, who love Hal Jordan. But then you get the group that was introduced to DC through Justice League.
Yep.
And they get their Green Lantern. You know, you get exactly what you said. We both get our Green Lantern. And that's the best way to do it.
Which, I mean, from the trailer for Justice League, we know lanterns have existed in this world.
I love that. Whenever you hear Steppenwolf say that there's no lanterns on this planet.
Yeah.
Like, oh. Yeah, just
which
amazing.
You know, he said no protectors, and then he said no lanterns, no Kryptonians.
Mm-hmm.
You know, lanterns and Kryptonians, that's one thing, but do you think he may be referring to somebody else or another group as protectors?
I think he just kind of means that there's no real,
just in general.
Yeah,
gotcha.
Because they haven't really, on a wide scale like that, built up to saying that Earth has protectors.
Yeah,
so you know, granted, you got Wonder Woman, but. Still, you know.
Yeah, I mean, the only other person I guess they could be referring to was Aquaman, because that's who they show when he says it, but, you know.
But that movie looks good, or that stuff looks good, which, so that's our eight, and I've mentioned a couple that we know are in the works. You know, we know Black Adam is in the works,
mm-hmm.
but it apparently doesn't have a slate.
Yeah.
We know that... Gotham City Sirens is in the works. We know that Nightwing is in the works.
Yep.
So, that's kind of interesting. Like, I wonder if it's just that's what they're saying. This is what's going to be ready to go in the next couple years, but not what we're making.
I don't know, man. It's hard to tell. It's like, just the way they announced... Like, that's the thing. The way they've announced stuff is just so weird compared to Marvel. It's like, you know... Three movies ahead, what's next? And you know when you go to see one movie, you're getting a setup or the stinger at the end for the next movie. And you already know what movie it's going to be most of the time.
Yeah. But I mean, that's... On that, though, we're getting to the end of knowing what Marvel stuff's next.
Yeah.
Like, after Avengers 4, we don't know what's coming.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting. Just to see what gets changed up and whatnot.
So I'm very interested to see what DC's got going on. I hope it's great. Like we were talking earlier, this is not in any way we do not buy into the DC versus Marvel fanboyism.
That's why we call ourselves comic book fans.
Yeah, I want more of everything. Yeah. Like, there's no reason to wish one side to do bad or to laugh when one side does bad. Because when comic book movies do bad, we as comic book fans don't win.
Yeah.
So I don't understand that. But yeah, I want everything to work out. Flipping to the Marvel side. We got a new Thor trailer.
Yes.
We did not get a new Avengers trailer, despite the fact that there was footage.
Yeah.
Which makes me mad in the day that we live in. Like, come on, man, release this stuff. Like, DC's been on point. Like,
except for that Batman Superman, the first trailer that they did, like, when they announced it.
Yeah, but we still ended up getting it, like, a week later.
No, not the first one. Not the very first announcement where it just showed Superman in the sky and Batman put the light on him. We didn't get that for almost a year. But other than that, they've been pretty quick about it.
Right.
But, I mean, I guess just they got to hold that Avengers trailer to at least after Thor for everybody else. But I get what you're saying because, like I just said, we know what's coming.
Yeah, there's no reason, like, you're not going to build any more anticipation by holding it.
If you haven't built what you want by 19 movies.
Yeah.
I mean, like, come on, man.
If you haven't already decided you're going to see the next Avengers movie, you're not going to see it. Like, it's just simple as that.
Which, if you're not going to see that, you're just stupid.
Doesn't matter what you think or what you believe. If you're not going to see it, you're stupid.
That's right.
new Thor trailer looked great. And you could tell, like, those ways that they were going with, like, those little ads where Thor's living with his roommate and doing the whole Team Thor thing.
Oh, yeah.
Like, over that. Like, you can tell they're going into this very funny place with Thor. It seems like he's getting way more of a sense of humor than he's had in the last couple movies.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know, man. I go back and forth on those movies, like, I like the first part of the first movie, and then I kind of forget about some of it, and then I just remember not liking the second one that much. I just remember they just threw away Christopher Eccleston. I was like, what the crap, man?
They're both entirely forgettable.
But
I think
this movie looks like it's what it needs to be.
Well, you want to know why? Like, I think the biggest thing that draws me to it, there's no Earth.
Yeah.
They're not on Earth. I don't care to see. Like, Thor has this cool mythology to it. Then I'm like, why are you showing me Earth stuff? I would much rather see Asgard. I'd much rather see all that. And I think that's the thing that's making me most excited about Ragnarok is I don't think they end up on Earth at all.
Yeah. I mean, and we've known forever that that's the key to the Guardians getting back and things like that. So it's like you said, they out 80s themselves with the trailer. So I was like, that's just cool.
And I don't know if you read the descriptions of the footage from Infinity War, but apparently, like, the Guardians run into Thor, kind of literally. Like, hits the spaceship.
Yeah, I watched the leaked trailer.
Oh, see, I didn't get a chance.
Yeah, it was, like, it's a weird camera angle, but yeah, like, he flat out is, like, bug on a windshield, and Rocket loses his crap. He's like, oh, God, get it off.
I saw a thing with Scarlett Johansson. Apparently, she was on maybe Conan or something like that. She said, there's 60-some Marvel characters in that movie, and one scene, there's 32 together.
So they doubled the DC TV crossover, because I think there were 17 heroes on that rooftop in the 4-episode crossover. But yeah, in the trailer, you actually see, like, Doctor Strange. He's, like, making these, like, kind of, like, I guess, like, just stairs for him to walk across, and you see Star-Lord just jumping and landing on whatever magical element that Doctor Strange is making for him to walk across. He's just walking by just blasting everything.
That's cool. I'm excited. Like, I'm trying to figure out, like, have there been 60-some named Marvel characters so far? Like, I'd have to sit down with it. That seems like a lot.
Yeah, it's, I guess if you take all the references and stuff like that to other people we've seen, then, you know, it's hard to tell. This may just be, like, one of those sayings where Thanos is, like, the great threat.
Yeah.
And people start coming out of the woodwork. Like, that's what I'm kind of thinking. Maybe that's why Captain Marvel was set in the 90s.
Mm-hmm.
Like, maybe she hasn't been active for a while, and gotcha. Thanos is what brings her back, which that's weird. I just don't understand why that movie's set in the 90s.
That is weird, because none of the Marvel stuff has been set in the past like that.
Other than Agent Carter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but it only had two seasons, and, you know, all the flashbacks we get and everything else from Captain America and the early part of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah.
So, and even she hasn't been referenced in that, so I don't know what they're doing.
Yeah, I mean, she's apparently they're going to tie her into a lot of the cosmic stuff, because they said the villains of that movie are the Skrulls.
Which, that surprised us, because didn't we think that was a Fox?
Super Skrull is Fox.
Gotcha.
So they actually have access to the race as Skrulls, but the character, the Super Skrull, is Fox.
See, I thought that was the reason that they did it, Chitauri in
Now, the Avenger. Chitauri were what they used for Ultimate Avengers, or the Ultimates.
Oh, okay.
That was the
Chitauri. I literally thought that was just plug-and-play characters because they didn't own the Skrulls.
They are.
Oh, okay.
They're very much, like, if you even go back and look through that stuff, like, it's very much supposed to be the Skrulls.
Oh, okay.
But at least they were a Marvel race. So, but set in the 90s, the Skrulls is a villain. Nick Fury being a major character in it, apparently. So.
Yeah. So they must have worked out a new contract for him, so that's good.
I'm wondering how they're going to tie in, like, her being in the 90s, because Ms. Marvel was in a coma in the comics for a long time.
Well, that might be.
But the reason she was in a coma for a long time is because Rogue attacked her and took all her powers.
Yeah, that kind of sucks, because you're not going to be able to play with Rogue with that. You're not going to be able to play with Storm's connection to Black Panther.
Yeah.
Always, it just irks me. Get your stuff together, Fox.
It'd be cool if they actually did, like, have him have a queen and just be like...
Just look like her, but yeah, never name her.
Long white hair and just never name her. Like, oh, that'd be so good. Funny.
I would.
So what else we got? Moving off some of the...
Let's see what we got here. 13th Doctor was announced.
Yes. And I am...
The internet lost its mind, apparently.
Yeah. But it received it a lot better than it did female Ghostbusters.
And, you know, and that's what we were talking about. Just the fact that, you know, it's already been established in Doctor Who that the Doctor can be a woman. And it's not ignoring what's come before. So that right there already has two reasons. I don't know it's going to work because... Has there been a bad Doctor Who episode?
Yeah.
Well, it seems like it's got, like, good writing behind it, though. Yeah.
And
so,
it's one of those things, everybody hates the, like, nobody buys into the new Doctor at first.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't matter, it could have been a guy, and nobody would have been excited. Everybody would be like, that's not the Doctor. It's stupid. And by the time that she regenerates, people are going to be super unhappy that she's leaving.
Yeah.
And they're not going to be excited about who the new Doctor is. So it's cyclical with the Doctor. It's been that way every single time.
Yeah. Well, it's like everybody just gets their favorite Doctor and, you know, you can't move past it. I mean, everybody has one that's a Doctor Who fan. So, and a lot of it kind of depends on when you come into Doctor Who. Yep. Like, who's the Doctor when you start watching it.
Yeah.
So there's going to be a lot of people out there that discover Doctor Who because of this, and that's cool.
And it's not even the first, like... Granted, it was out of continuity, but there's been a female Doctor before.
And oh, wasn't it some joke skit or something?
Yeah, the 20-minute episode that Stephen Moffat did in 99, The Curse of Fatal Death, when he regenerates into a woman.
There is a there's a cosplayer. She calls herself Abby Darkstar, and she always does the sassy Doctor a lot of times. And it's David Tennant. A skirt most of the time. It's pretty funny looking, but it's pretty cool. But, yeah, I think this is going to go over a lot better than Answer to the Call tried to. You know, you can't ignore something that's got a, Ghostbusters had a 30-year history.
Yeah.
But Doctor Who's got, what, 50-some?
50-some-year history.
And the fact that they're not ignoring what's come before. Yeah, I mean, why wouldn't it work?
Absolutely. And as long as it's got a good writing team behind it, as long as... They have the characteristics. I mean, it's going to be the Doctor.
Isn't it the guy who took over, like, he worked on Broadchurch? with David Tennant, and I think that's where she came from.
Because she comes from Broadchurch.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's
because I know it's not Moffat. Moffat's done at the Christmas special.
Yeah, because I'm fairly certain that's who's taking over the show. Gotcha. And you know,
which I haven't. I'm probably not going to sit down and catch up. I need to, but I'm far enough behind where I'm not. I'm going to watch Christmas special this year because like the idea of them going back to the first Doctor and having a two-part Doctor episode or a Doctor. Multiple Doctor episode with the first Doctor. Who's really cool?
Who's the guy they got to play him?
David Bradley.
Yeah, that's right. Because he looks so much like the first Doctor. So
right off a cloned William Hartnell. It's ridiculous.
That scene that we've seen online where his face morphs, it's so seamless.
Yeah.
Like there was no... I'm sure there was some CGI there, but it wasn't like, you know, like when you see young Robert Downey Jr. in Civil War. It wasn't anything like that. It was just almost seamless.
Yeah. No, it's nuts. And
I mean, I guess a big part of it was fading from black and white into color. Yeah. That helped it, but dude looks like him.
And they're tying it to the first Doctor's regeneration episode.
Yeah.
Like, they're on the planet that the first Doctor regenerates on, so it's like you're going to get both regenerations. That'd be neat if they actually do kind of move, like you see... William Hartnell transfer into Patrick Troughton. Like,
yeah, that's what I was wondering.
That would be kind of cool. So, yeah, I'm definitely excited about that one. Now, I'm not... This next one, I didn't pay as much attention to as clearly you did.
Oh, the Ghostbuster announcement?
Yeah, like, I saw some of the stuff, but it seems like you have more information than I do.
Okay, like, there's a Facebook page... Ghostbusters Incorporated Worldwide.
Uh-huh.
That's they seem to be on top of it, and I was sitting there watching, you know, basically watching the stories unfold through their feed.
Right.
And then I would, you know, of course, look in to see what was happening and whatnot. But apparently what they're saying is there's two, like, Ivan Reitman addressed the crowd, saying that he understood and he heard what we've been saying, what all the fans have been saying about, we didn't totally hate Answer the Call. We just had a lot of issues with it, and the main thing was, why in the hell was it not, you know, set in the established universe?
Right.
Apparently that was Ivan Reitman and Dan Aykroyd's biggest concern, too.
Right.
And, you know, apparently we heard the stories from the email hacks about Bill Murray, about how he was basically had to be in it or he was going to get sued.
Yeah.
And his performance in that movie, you could tell he just does not want to be there. But yeah, apparently what they're doing is there's...
Unfortunately, I think if they had actually made a regular Ghostbusters movie, we'd have probably gotten roughly the same performance out of Bill Murray.
Yeah, but I don't know. I think he could have actually been on set and kind of been like, you know what? This was fun. I remember this. And he would have probably got... I mean, you even have the scene in Zombieland where you could tell he's having fun with it. But the fact that he had Bill Murray in a Ghostbusters movie and he was not a Ghostbuster, That's just terrible. But now the big thing is apparently we're getting two movies, one of which is a live-action movie, and the other is an animated movie.
Gotcha.
And they said that the TV show that they had, the cartoon that they were working on, which I think was called Ecto-Force, they're putting it on hold in favor of these. And Ivan Reitman is back over it.
Gotcha.
No Paul Feig or Feig or
whatever his name was. Not going to be around.
Yeah, because I think Dan Aykroyd kind of blasted him a little while back saying that, you know, the girls tried, they did okay, but, you know, so that Paul's big problem was he wouldn't listen to any of the original creative force behind the original project. So, I mean, which you can tell.
Which is three people.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, that's the thing. The creative force behind the original two Ghostbusters is... three people.
Yeah. And when you
Ivan
can't...
Ivan Reitman, Harold Ramis, Dan Aykroyd.
And, you know, when you had something that works and you don't want to listen to the people who created it, of course you're not going to do great.
Yeah.
But the fact that Ivan is back over this and Dan Aykroyd's right there by his side, I'm happy.
Well, here's the thing. I'm happy that there's something else happening because, like, as much as we both love Ghostbusters, I'm going to have to see something first.
I didn't want it to die on that hill.
No, yeah, here's the thing. I'm glad that they're not going to let... Like, the idea is they're not going to let Ghostbusters be dead. And that's it.
Yeah.
And that makes me happy. Now, as far as me being excited for anything, I'm going to have to see something.
Yeah, I totally get you. Because, I mean, how many years did we hear Ghostbusters 3 was happening?
Yeah.
So, but, I don't know, man. You don't set up a section in Sony called Ghost Corps and not plan to do anything with it. So, I mean, they've invested some money in that. It's almost like they did Marvel, like how Marvel Studios broke off into its own thing.
Yeah.
You've got a studio inside Sony just dedicated to Ghostbusters right now.
Yeah.
So, I guess we'll have to play the waiting game, see what happens. But
I mean, I'm excited to see, like I said, well, I'm interested to see what happens. Like, to me, I don't know. It's one of those things to where I'm not 100% certain I want, I'm trying to think of a way to say this. I would rather the animated movie be the one that involves the previous cast.
The, like the actual, like, the real, like Air Ghostbusters?
Yeah.
It is. It's set they're calling it Ghostbuster Prime is what, you know.
But it's like,
well, not that that movie's called, just, the, you know, anything that deals with the first group is called Ghostbusters Prime.
But it's like, I don't know if there's a lot of, like, I don't know how well those guys can. I would almost rather see something like the video game, like I said, where you can make them, age them down in animation back to what they were in the 90s or whatever, and then do the voices.
Yeah.
Versus trying to do something with them now. But also, I don't want another group of Ghostbusters. Like, that's why I don't want the anime, like, a live action movie. It's like, I know it's going to be something like, oh, we're going to put another group together, and it's in the regular universe, but it's still a group of other people that, you know, like, I don't think that franchise can work with anybody else.
I mean, the only way you could do it, if you want to do it, like, you're going to have to do a new group, though, sadly.
Yeah, that's the thing. I think that's why it's, I mean, it's, you're right, it's going to
You're going to have to do it, like, Batman Beyond, where Bruce kind of controls everything from behind the scenes.
Well, your extreme and, Ghostbusters idea. Yeah.
So that's basically what we're, I think we're heading toward is a live action extreme Ghostbusters type deal. Not just saying it is that, I'm just saying. But it's funny that you mentioned a video game because apparently that was another part of the announcement. Ivan said that the video game is not canon anymore.
Yeah.
It's not the unofficial part
until
3.
Until they give me something that's... like I said, it works as Ghostbusters 3 to me until they give me a reason to say that it doesn't.
It's like, the last one burnt you so bad, you're just afraid to go back in the kitchen right now.
I think it's what it is. Like, there's a part of me where I was like, I never would have been unhappy about new Ghostbusters stuff, and now I'm like, I'm not interested in a lot of ways.
But hopefully it'll work out for the best.
That's what I'm hoping. I mean, I want more Ghostbusters. I want.
They can't. So much... They can't screw it up anymore than what they tried last year.
No, not at all. And even what they did do got us so much original Ghostbusters stuff.
Yeah.
Like all the new Diamond Select figures, which you got the new Ghostbusters 2 and Real Ghostbusters Waves coming out.
The Proton
packs you just ordered.
Next year?
The new props and stuff that we're getting. Mattel's putting, you know.
And it's funny, too, because which props are they making?
Yeah. Well, what I'm hoping, if Mattel's putting the PKE meter back up, I have a feeling that's probably the cheapest one. They're going to put it up and see
what goes.
How it goes. Mm-hmm. And it would not shock me to see the trap and everything else start making its way back out from Mattel if that sells.
Yeah.
So,
I'm not going to make the mistake again.
No,
the
I will
minute
buy,
it's announced, pre-order.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not letting that stuff go away again. Because a lot of people who even make good, like the regular, or like the full-out nice scale packs, use the Mattel wand.
Yeah.
Instead of building one.
Yeah.
So, you know, that stuff was really well done. And the fact that, looking back, it was pretty cheap.
Yeah, I mean, as long as we keep it in the public eye, so we get what we want, I'm happy.
Yeah, you know what, I'll take a punch in the gut once or twice every
you know
30
what?
Years to...
Do it, like, if, say, this animated movie takes off and we love it, that's our next DC animated movies. Yeah. Do the Ghostbusters like the DC animated movies every so, like, to a year.
Yeah. Oh, which, I didn't even think of those, bringing those back up, jumping back, even though we left DC... The next 4 DC animated movies were announced.
Let's see. I remember Batman and
Gotham,
Harley.
Well, that's the one coming out this year. I'm talking about the 4 after that.
Oh, okay.
So you've got Gotham by Gaslight.
What was it? Batman, or not Batman, Superman. The Death of Superman.
You've got Death of Superman and Reign of the Superman. And why can't I remember the third or the fourth one? The one that comes in between those.
Can't remember. I remember you sent me the message. Because I kind of totally forgot about it, though. But think they're doing a Death of Superman as a two-parter? Since it's been 10 years since that was the first one, and it was kind of a condensed version of that story.
Well, I did think that was weird to go with two movies based around that when that was the first one you led off with.
You know what I really think it is? They did a condensed version of that story,
mm-hmm.
and then they saw how good that The Dark Knight Returns worked as a two-parter.
Right.
And so they decided, they were like, expand. You know what? We can actually do a Christopher Nolan-length movie of this and actually kind of make it work with two parts instead of just forcing everything into one smaller movie.
Yeah, and the idea of them doing the Reign of the Superman sounds pretty cool. Like, I'm really excited about that. So, I'm all for that. Like, I love all these movies. So, the idea of getting more of them and, yeah, Superman Doomsday is one of the weakest of that run.
It's like, the biggest thing I remember is, what's the dude who played Spike on Buffy? James
Marsters.
Yeah, I remember he did the voice for Lex, and Kevin Smith had a cameo in it. That's like the biggest standout that I remember about that movie. And then they, when they did, like, when he came back, wasn't it like two different versions of Superman in two different people or something like that?
I'm trying to remember. You mean in that movie?
Yeah, it's like they kind of mixed it.
I bet you I haven't seen that movie since
it came out.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I do remember it just being kind of forced together. But I still can't remember what that other one was, though.
I can't either, and it's not pulling up for me. So it seems like it was a new Suicide Squad one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Sweet.
So whether it's going to be set... Hopefully it'd be set in the Arkham universe.
Oh, that'd be cool to come back to that, because that's a guaranteed Hamill and Conroy.
Yeah.
So
that would be pretty cool.
That would be nice.
All right. What else we got here? Ready Player One.
Yeah, that looks interesting.
That, I've been waiting on something for that for a while.
See, it's funny. I was going to say, that's one of the ones I keep hearing you and Jamie talk about.
It's so good. Like... And it's one of those things here. I've come across this idea over the last little bit. The internet does not allow me to like things. Or like certain parts of Reddit think you're stupid if you like things. And everybody talks, like, the vast majority of people when they talk about Ready Player One keep talking about, oh, the book's terrible. It's terribly written. It's nothing but popcorn trash and 80s references. I'm like, so? Like, we're in a world where Fast and Furious makes $90 billion. Like, there's nothing wrong with popcorn movies. There's nothing wrong with that. Popcorn literature can work the exact same way.
Yeah.
And I thought it was just, it's such a good book. Like, fun adventure story. It's the book version of a summer blockbuster.
Gotcha.
Just chock full of 80s references.
Yeah.
And... that's the biggest thing going into it, was trying to figure out, all right, how are they going to play with all of these licenses? Because there's got to be 300-400 different licensed.
Well, yeah, that's like what in the trailer you
in
saw.
This movie.
The DeLorean.
In this book.
And Iron Giant.
Yeah.
That was a big standout.
You get the movie, and within like one of the first shots in the Oasis in the movie, you see the Iron Giant. And it's like, oh, that's so cool. Which, in the book, one of the big parts, like Mechagodzilla is a big part of the book.
Really?
And I'm wondering if Iron Giant takes that place.
Eh, could be the whole plug and play with what you own.
Yeah, I have a feeling that's what it is. Like, Ernest Cline, the author, kind of said that he's really glad that it went to Warner Brothers because they owned a lot of the properties that were in the book anyway. But apparently Spielberg has said that the Iron Giant's a pretty decent... part of the movie.
Really?
Which I'm hoping means enough to get Vin Diesel back.
Ah, oh, that'd be cool.
And since it's Warner Brothers, I'm like, can I have the Iron Giant meet Superman?
Like, oh my god,
that
dude.
Happen in this? But yeah, like the main character apparently is driving, you know, seeing Okay, I'm definitely against remaking Back to the Future in any way.
Oh, yeah, no. And apparently there's literature that that will never happen. So,
but I'm not going to lie. Seeing the DeLorean running through the streets in that trailer, it sparked something. Just the idea of seeing it in that new element was like, oh, man. Like, don't get me wrong. Hopefully that will satiate that, and I don't have to worry about, like, wanting to see anything else. Just the car will be enough. But that race has, like, if you look around in that race, the A-Team van's in there.
Yeah.
Laura Croft is in there. Christine from the Stephen King novel and movie is in there.
Oh, wow.
Mad Max's Interceptor.
So basically, if they can get it, they got it.
Yeah. The main girl is driving, or one of the girls, like Artemis, is the love interest kind of in the movie, is driving Canada's bike from Akira.
Okay, I remember that.
And even does the long slide with her hands on the ground. And you look in there and see Harley Quinn and Deathstroke walk past him as he's walking into this nightclub.
Really?
Yeah.
I did not see that.
We'll have to pull it up here in a little bit. But it shows him kill... one of the characters is jumping around with the pulse rifle from Halo, killing Freddy Krueger and Duke Nukem in the same scene. Like, oh, it's... I cannot wait for this. And to me, it's like, wondering how they're going to get all this stuff. It's Steven Spielberg. Like, this is the guy that got Disney and Warner Brothers to play with each other in the 90s.
Yeah.
Like, he's the reason that we got Mickey Mouse and Mickey, or, yeah, Mickey Mouse and Bugs Bunny together in the same movie.
Yeah.
So, I just have a feeling, like, that's Spielberg being like, I'm going to figure this out. Like, don't worry about it.
So, I got you.
That has, I'm so excited about the possibilities for that movie. Like, I'm... And it kills me, like, seeing, like I said, it's like we're not allowed to like things. So many people are already on there, like, oh my God, this looks terrible. It looks awful. It's going to be terrible. They're going to kill the book and all this stuff. Like, just be excited about something.
Yeah.
It's like, you know what? I'm going into what possibly has more potential than not in a week of seeing my favorite book of all time decimated on screen. Next week with Dark Tower.
Right.
I'm still excited to go see the movie. Like, I'm giving it a chance. And hopefully they'll work together and it'll be this cool, like, two separate universes I don't have to worry about. And I'm getting more of what I like. Like, that's what I want. And hopefully this leads to it. Because they're already saying they're getting ready to do the TV show. Which is going to be the fourth book, Wizard and Glass. Because the whole fourth book is a flashback.
Oh, okay.
So, they're already going to do that. And then there's the possibility of sequels. And the director's already said... The director didn't ask me anything on Reddit the other day. And really came across as a big fan.
That's good.
And he came across as a huge fan. And one of the things that I really liked is he said that Stephen King watched a cut of the movie and told him that... one of the big things in the Dark Tower universe is... being told you've forgotten the face of your father. That's basically like, you've screwed up. You're terrible. Like, that's one of the biggest insults that Roland can give you. And the director said that, you know, when King watched the movie, he told him, he was like, no, you've definitely remembered the face of your father. So it's like, that's a pretty high praise from the Dark Tower universe. But that being said, Stephen King's also really liked crap versions of his stuff before. So.
Sorry, I just got a thing on my phone that said Chris Jericho returned tonight. So.
What is tonight? Oh, so he's on SmackDown?
Yep.
Hmm. Interesting. Not enough to make me care, but. But also, homie from. Did he cut his face off?
Yeah, I'm telling you, man, Gotham is doing a lot of new 52 stuff. Yeah, we got the trailers playing in the background again, but yeah, it's like they kind of pulled that last season. Straight up just got his face cut off. And Huh. Kind of did a smaller version of that, so.
Why is he going to be every version? That's not his show.
Nah, man, last season was good, trust me. Season 3 was really good.
If that's the case, would it actually be all right if I just jumped to season 3 and didn't watch
actually,
seasons
you know what?
1 and 2?
They were doing a thing with Gotham where they were taking each season and they were calling it something after the first season. It's like you had the first half of season 1 was called something and the second half of season 2 was called something else. It was
seeing Riddler and Mr. Freeze and all these characters actually in costume kind of...
It's awesome, dude, because I think, what was it, City of Villains and... Or Rise of the Villains and then City of the Villains, they're breaking each season up into two parts, basically.
Gotcha.
And yeah, it's been really good. Like the whole, like this right here, you see her taking her first steps to actually become, and she looks like Michelle Pfeiffer.
A little bit,
Pfeiffer so
yeah.
much it's ridiculous. So I don't know, man. There's a lot about it. I'm like, oh boy. But there's a lot about it I like. Like you said, seeing these guys in costumes and stuff like that, it's almost like they're trying to turn it into a modern day 66 Batman show.
Kinda. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it had a little touch of hokiness.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like they're having fun with it now because
but Riddler in a bowler hat. And...
Season 1 was a police procedural, like right. The whole thing with Ra's al Ghul and you know bringing in. I mean, you were getting
is that Bruce?
Yeah, that's Bruce.
Oh, that kid's almost like 45 years old now. Like,
so he's Batman age. So, yeah, man, it's like
what?
Yeah, it's. I'm telling you, man, they play with the Lazarus Pit and stuff like that, so it's fun, dude. If you like Batman, I mean, you need... Yeah, like, I would actually recommend you just jump on season 2. Like, ignore it and just...
Gotcha.
Get through season 3.
Huh.
So, it's fun.
And like I said, seeing... This trailer has made me more interested in this show than I have been... Oh, and that's actually, like, him...
Yeah,
almost in
this...
the iconic Batman pose with a mask. And that being said, he's pulling the Clark Kent school of superheroing.
You can't call
seen
yourself...
Seen a dude in a black trench coat standing on a rooftop quite a few times. Jake goes into, we talked a little bit about it earlier today, but another one of these movies we didn't get to is the fact that, you know, Spawn might finally happen.
Thanks to our boy Kevin Smith.
Yeah. Which... I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I'll believe it when I own the Blu-ray. Like,
yeah.
I won't even believe that I've seen the movie in theaters. I will need to have it constantly referenced.
That's just one of those characters. Like, I know of him. I've seen the movie. I just didn't... I wasn't all that excited about
You
him.
Shouldn't. There's nothing about that movie to be excited. You need to watch the HBO series.
Okay.
It's on HBO Go. It's so good. It's
really?
3 seasons, like 6 half-hour episodes animated each.
Okay.
That's Spawn. Like, gotcha. I would rather watch that than ever watch the movie again.
Okay.
So, anything else from Comic-Con?
Not that I can think of, man. I think we pretty much talked about everything we've been excited about.
Yeah. Not even a lot of toys this year. Like, the rest... Toys, it seemed like WWE and Mattel were the ones that hit the toys
like,
more out of the park this year. Like...
Everything I got excited about seemed like it was coming out of WWE's lineup, but...
Yeah, other than...
I mean, the Hot Toys for Justice League,
yeah,
those looked insane.
Hot Toys might as well not exist to me. They're so far out of my price range.
It's like, you want to pay your rent or you need a figure?
Yeah, I know, right? But I'm excited, like, some of the Nika stuff, Nika teasing the fact that they're going to be doing more Ninja Turtle stuff, which, from the sound of it, might be... 6-7 inch movie original 90s movie figures.
Yeah, I remember you telling me about this last night.
That I'm hoping for, you know, them saying that it's going to be even bigger than this, even bigger, more figures than this set. Oh wow, he straight up is Mr. Terrific now.
Yeah, dude, they're doing some good stuff on these shows. Like they've picked up, man. Like, I mean, don't get me wrong, I've liked them since day one, but you suffer through some stuff, but you do get a good payoff.
Hmm. But, you know, this season, or this year's 8 figures, all 4 Turtles, Shredder, Krang, 2 Foot Soldiers, and that awesome carrying case, and they're saying that next year's bigger and better. Said I'm calling it now. It's the 90s figures. It's those quarter-scale figures scaled down to 7 inch. So all four turtles, April, Splinter, Casey, Shredder, Tatsu, and a couple foot soldiers. Like, that's, I'm going to call it.
Yeah. That'd be a good set, though.
Yeah, I've already decided I'm going to have to go ahead and just save up money to go ahead and grab that. But yeah, none of the, like, the Justice League stuff from Mattel looked, eh.
Yeah.
Marvel Legends looked pretty good.
Yeah, well, didn't you say there's some new technology with what they're doing with that?
Yeah, the face scan stuff when they get to the Hasbro stuff. And, you know, now the fact that they're able to make these figures really look a lot better and a lot more like the actors that are playing them, which is going to make me probably have to rebuy tons of my Black Series figures, which is not going to make me happy. But, yeah, like I said, I don't know what it was this year. Just kind of more of a, not a letdown, but not as, oh my God, it's San Diego. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, it seems like last year we were kind of going crazy more about toys than we were movies, and this year it's opposite.
Yeah, I agree. All right, but for San Diego Comic-Con this year, that wraps us up. Our next two episodes we got to talk about, or at least our next two topics. I don't know how we're going to do episode count. We'll see when we get there. But we got Planet of the Apes. Was it War for the Planet of the Apes this go-around?
Something ridiculously long like that.
Yeah. Rise of the Dawn of the War for the Planet of the Apes beneath the Conquest Planet.
The sequel. Search for More Money.
And we've got what seems to be one of the more interesting possible episodes of Real Talk coming up when we talk about Valerian and the City of 1,000 Planets.
Oh, boy.
Apparently it's going to be our first real major split decision episode. So stay tuned for that for this week's Real Talk. I've been Shane.
I've been Robbie.
And we'll see you at the movies. We'll be right back.